Your monthly subscription box from postflybox.com includes all the materials needed to tie a dozen flies, along with some extra goodies. The orange sherbet is a relatively easy to tie, high floating hopper pattern that fish just can't seem to resist. Whether used alone or as part of a hopper dropper system, it works incredibly well, especially during summer and early fall. Begin by getting hold of one of the size 6 hooks along with a pre-cut foam orange hopper body and a set of plastic eyes. With the materials assembled, use your bodkin to poke a hole through the squared off end of the foam. This will be used to hold the plastic eyes in place. The hole left by the bodkin is fairly small. Heating the bodkin and using it to enlarge the hole will make inserting the eyes into that hole much easier. Once you have the eyes in place, check to make sure they're symmetrical and won't fall out. On the bottom side of the hopper body, you should find a thin slit. Insert your hook bend first into this slit and pull it around into position. Try to keep the hook gap as open as possible. Using your bodkin, place a small amount of superglue into the slit on top of the hook. Then, pick up the assembly, make sure the hook is oriented correctly, and give the foam a firm squeeze. You need to do this for a few seconds in order to properly set the adhesive. Once done, the foam body should be well attached to the hook. Then, you can get the whole assembly firmly secured in the jaws of your tying vise. Load a bobbin with the spool of fluorescent orange unithread. Get the thread started approximately 1/3 of the way down the foam body. Keep taking tighter and tighter wraps as you go to compress the foam. You can then snip the excess tag end off close. Get hold of one of the knotted rubber leg segments and lay it at an angle against the near side of the hook so the knot is in line with the back edge of the hook bend. Start taking wraps of tying thread to anchor the material to the near side of the hopper body. Pick up a second knotted rubber leg segment and use the same tie-in procedure to anchor it to the far side of the body. Reach in with your tying scissors and carefully snip the excess rubber leg material off on both sides. Separate the 3 strands of rubber leg material and snip off the one on the front edge. Snip the one on the back edge, leaving about 1/4 inch, then trim the center leg so it's about 1/2 inch in length. Repeat the same procedure on the other side. To add a little shimmer to the wing, snip 3 or 4 strands of pearl crystal flash free from the hank. Find the midpoint of the strands and snip them there. You can stash 1/2 of these away for later use on another orange sherbet. Lay the midpoint of the remaining strands on top of the foam body and take thread wraps to secure it. Pull the front strands rearward and use wraps of tying thread to pin them back. Snip the strands off so they're even with the back edge of the foam. Get hold of one of the pheasant feathers and strip the lower fuzzy fibers free from the stem. Place the feather on top of the body so its tip extends to the back edge of the foam. Take wraps of tying thread to secure it. Lift the stem up and trim the butt end of the feather off nice and close. Pull down on your bobbin to expose about 4 inches of tying thread and use the orange dubbing to build up a fairly long, thin noodle on the thread. Start taking wraps with the noodle to cover up the snipped off ends at the tie-in point. Take another wrap of tying thread to center it in the band of dubbing. Pull 2 strands free from the sheet of rubber leg material, then separate them. Set one aside and bring the other underneath your tying thread from the far side of the fly to the near side. With the second strand, just pull it underneath the thread on the far side, then give both strands a squeeze and anchor them with a couple tight turns of tying thread. Snip off 1/4 inch length of the multicolored thin foam and lay it over top of the dubbing band. Take a few wraps of tying thread to compress and anchor the piece, which will allow you to better see the fly on the water surface. Pull down on your bobbin once again, this time to expose just a small amount of tying thread, and use the orange dubbing to build up a thin, inch-long noodle. Take wraps with a noodle to cover any exposed thread, then bring your thread from the far side of the fly underneath the hook and around a couple of times at the back edge of the hook eye. Trim the front rubber legs so each is about an inch in length. Doing two at a time will help keep them even. With the legs trimmed and reasonably out of the way, pick up your whip finish tool and do a 4 or 5 turn whip finish, seat the knot well, and snip your tying thread free. And that's the orange sherbet. It's one of the easiest hopper patterns to tie, and it also happens to be one of the best floating.